Hi, this is Noel Wurst with Techwell, and I am sitting here with the pragmatic manager, Johanna Rothman. How are you this morning?
I'm great, thanks, Noel. How are you?
Doing just fine. We are speaking with Johanna today because she is going to be heading up the Software Managers Lab, which is something new that is going to be done at the Agile Development Conference, Better Software Conference West in Las Vegas, Nevada, and that lab will be held on Wednesday, June 5th. So we just had some questions for you today about that lab, what all it's going to be, and what people can expect who attend it.
All right.
Well, first of all, since it's brand new, what is it? And what should attendees be excited about getting to see?
Well, it's not so much see as do.
That's true.
Yeah. So one of the things we're going to practice is feedback, because you can never practice feedback enough. It's really hard to give feedback in the office setting, because it happens behind a door all too often.
Mm-hmm.
And especially if you're doing Agile, you have to be able to give feedback one-on-one, in a group setting. And how do you learn how to give feedback to people? You have to be able to practice it. And although it's called a manager's lab,
mm-hmm.
you have to be able to practice it and in a peer setting. This is not like, you've done a bad job. No.
Right.
This is, how do I give feedback to you as a peer? How do you give feedback to me as a peer? And so, although it's called the manager's lab, we will be practicing giving peer-to-peer feedback. This is what Esther Derby and I wrote about in Behind Closed Doors, Secrets of Great Management. So if you know the peer-to-peer model of feedback, we'll be practicing and practicing and practicing, but only in what, a 45-minute session?
Yeah, I think that's what I saw.
Yeah, it's 45 minutes of practice.
Right.
So, speed feedback.
Cool.
And then we're going to do speed coaching.
Speaking of the coaching, and when I was reading the abstract for it, I mentioned that the three most important skills for software managers are guiding, coaching, and leading, and started thinking about how all three of those, just like Agile, really rely on being able to communicate well. I was going to see, now that you kind of explained how the feedback works, how are you kind of tackle improving communication skills?
So the idea with communication skills is you have to, it's that very fine line between how do you insert yourself into a conversation and yet allow people to come to you. One of the nice things about Agile is that you have rituals for communication. You have a stand-up every day, and you have the iteration planning. You have release planning that happens less often, and you have the retrospective that happens at the end of every iteration.
Mm-hmm.
If you're working in flow, you have minimum marketable features that you work on at less rhythmic intervals. So how do you have conversations with people where you're not interfering, but you have options for when people discuss stuff with you.
Mm-hmm.
So you still need one-on-ones, but you don't have them every week necessarily, or do you? So I suspect that one of the conversations we'll have in the management lab is, when do you have one-on-ones? And probably once every couple of weeks is the right cadence. Certainly, if you're in one-week iterations, you don't want a one-on-one every week. If you're having two-week iterations, once every couple weeks is the right cadence.
Mm-hmm.
If you're having three-week iterations, certainly once every couple weeks is the right cadence. And what do you do with a really serious introvert? You have to be really careful with these people, because you don't want to plop yourself down into their office and say, so, how's it going? That's the wrong thing.
Right.
And yet, at the same time, these people need to be drawn gently out of their shells so that they do participate fully. And with extroverts, how do you give them the feedback that if they just perk all around, that may be hurting the team also? So I suspect that we will have so much fodder for discussion,
mm-hmm.
that even though everything I prepare will be prepared in a handout or several handouts, I may just have the handouts and give them out, and we may talk about everything else.
Cool.
So I'll be prepared for going through handouts or just giving them out, that talking about whatever happens.
Great.
Yeah.
So kind of going back to that peer-to-peer feedback model that you were discussing, what's unique about that that could improve the way that people have maybe given feedback in the past who maybe were not exposed or were not that aware of that model?
So I think a lot of times people who gave feedback thought it was their responsibility to tell people what they were doing wrong and not telling people what they were doing right. So a peer-to-peer feedback model says you can use this model in reinforcing feedback. So if you're doing something right, you want to use the same model for everything. I really like it when people tell me that I'm doing right. Mm-hmm. I would like it if they tell me more often when I'm doing right.
Yeah.
So the same model works for everything. The other thing is that it's not talking down to people. It's not a teaching model. It's not something you would get from school. And I think that this is really important. It's not a parent-child model.
Right.
It's a peer-to-peer model. You can use it with your manager. You can use it with your manager's manager. It's not going down or up. It's peer-to-peer. So I think that that's very important. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't matter. So it doesn't matter where you are in the organization. It doesn't matter if you use it for correcting or reinforcing feedback. And it doesn't matter if you use it in private or in public. It's the same words. It all discusses how your actions affect me personally. So since you're not using it for blaming, you're just talking about facts. It makes a very big difference on how things work in the organization.
Okay. And then finally, now that I've been to a handful of these conferences myself and gotten to see the one-on-one opportunities that people get, that was one of the first things that I saw, just how enamored these people were with getting to sit down with their favorite authors and coaches and leaders and experts. And so I was kind of curious. I saw there was going to be one-on-one time at the Software Managers Lab and was curious as to what you're hoping to be able to answer for people, provide for people in that amount of time that they get to sit down with you.
Well, I have answered all kinds of interesting things.
Yeah.
People have said, I want to transition to Agile. What do I do? I have five introverts on my team and one extrovert, and the extrovert is screwing things up. And as an extrovert myself, I can sympathize with that extrovert. I have people on my team all over the world. I don't know how to bring them together. I'm an expert on geographically distributed teams. So I get all kinds of very interesting questions in the one-on-ones. And it's 15 minutes, so speed consulting.
Right.
The operative word for the manager's lab is, it's all about speed, right? It's skimming the surface, and I'll be providing hopefully enough references for people that they can then take that stuff and go from there. Mm-hmm. But the idea is that I give people enough information that they can take it from there. But I have such a good time, and people get enough gems that they get places to start. And they're so resourceful. The people I meet are so resourceful that they can say, okay, I have a couple of things I can do something with, and now I can go on.
Yeah.
So, and they find that really helpful. Mm-hmm. I find it really helpful. And I always get something in return, which is why I do it.
Cool.
Yeah, it works out really well.
Well, I will be out there as well and look forward to stopping by and seeing how it goes. This was our conversation again with Johanna Rothman, who is going to be leading the Software Managers Lab at the Agile Development Better Software Conference West in Las Vegas, Nevada, and that's going to be on Wednesday, June 5th. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you, Noel. I appreciate it.